the shutdown on CNN Philippines shows the dire state of legacy media. The National Union of Journalists of the Philippines says the closure shows a real problem in the industry that's being observed globally. How news as a business can survive as the viewing habits of the public changes. Despite the circumstances, the group calls on journalists to press on.
Shutting down a media company is no small issue because journalism is public service. Yes. Diba? Alam natin yan, hindi naman yan isang simpleng kumpanya lang. Pero meron siyang pinaglilingkurang audience, and this has impacts on our democracy. So yung plurality of media sources ay apektado din. I see the shrinking of democratic spaces, and it's proof that the plurality is also shrinking, and it's not good for any democracy. Yes, small and independent newsrooms still exist.
Yeah.
Although sa broadcast, medyo ang hirap, no? With the closure of CNN Philippines, malaking dagok ito para sa lahat.
CNN Philippines officially signs off today after nearly a decade on air. The Philippine government's media agencies assure a visiting UN special rapporteur they uphold the public's right to information. The assurance was given to Irene Khan by the Philippine Information Agency, the Bureau of Broadcast Services, and the Philippine News Agency. They emphasize their unwavering advocacy for the people's right to information and the preservation of freedom of expression and opinion. Khan also met with the Commission on Human Rights as well as former Senator Laila De Lima, who was released late last year after nearly 7 years of detention on what she claims are trumped-up drug charges by the Duterte administration. Philippine lawmakers moving to address gaps in issuing discounts to senior citizens and persons with disabilities, Vivian Gulia reports.
Can we do away with this booklet, Mr. Chair? It's so freaking useless.
House Deputy Majority Leader and ACT-CIS Party List Representative Erwin Tulfo issued this call during Tuesday's joint inquiry of two House panels into the gaps in implementing discounts for senior citizens and persons with disability. That's as the hearing revealed challenges in monitoring the grocery purchases of individuals belonging to the sector, despite the booklet requirement. This seeks to ensure compliance to the 1,300 peso weekly limit for the total online and offline purchases of basic necessities and prime commodities, which may be covered by the senior or PWD discount. An official of the Department of Social Welfare and Development said several local government units do not have enough manpower to do the monitoring, but discussions with private establishments are underway to create a database for this purpose.
Most of them, they do not have enough personnel nga po to really monitor the implementation of these social welfare and development programs.
There will obviously be a need to harmonize like the physical purchases with the purchases online. And definitely, we would need to work hand in hand with our partners in the private sector for that.
Instead of recording grocery purchases of seniors and PWDs in a booklet, Marikina 2nd District Representative Stella Kimbo proposed the creation of a mobile application. But for House Deputy Majority Leader and ACT-CIS Party List Representative Erwin Tulfo and United Senior Citizens Party List Representative Milagros Aquino Magsaysay, the booklet requirement should be completely scrapped for senior citizens.
Eh, hindi naman kamahalan yon at hindi naman ganun ka hirap yun. Napakahirap yung booklet. Dapat sa telepono na lang.
I think we have to do away with this booklet because this is useless. This is an insult to all the senior citizens because para mong tinitignan ng mga merchants, ng mga business establishment, para mga manluloko ang mga senior citizen natin. But hindi ba enough yung senior citizen ID? Yung sinasabi natin 1,300, 5%, ilimus lang ho yun eh.
I find it useless na iyan yung booklet. Bakit pa kailangan ng booklet na ipakita ko anong pinurchase mo, ko ano-ano mo, and napeg ka na sa 65 pesos.
The Food and Drug Administration meanwhile clarified during the hearing that doctor's prescription is not a requirement for availing of senior citizen or PWD discounts on over-the-counter medicines. Tulfo has been added to the technical working group that will be working on the bill, seeking to address the gaps in the implementation of discounts for seniors and PWDs. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
influential business group wants government to appoint a traffic chief who would take charge of addressing road congestion in the capital region. Johnson Manaba tells us more.
The Management Association of the Philippines issued its recommendation to help ease the traffic in Metro Manila, which includes the appointment of a traffic czar to command all stakeholders in order to decongest the capital's main thoroughfare. MAP Chairman of Transportation and Infrastructure Committee Eduardo Yap told ABS-CBN News that the government must first admit that there is a problem. Yap said a traffic czar should be appointed by the president and should be given full powers to mobilize, direct, and deploy existing government resources to ease traffic in the metro.
Actually, it has been existing since before the pandemic. Kaya ang kailangan talaga madeklara na isang traffic crisis para matauhan ba ang lahat.
Motorcycle Rights Organization Chairman Jobert Bolanos welcomes the proposal, but he admits it won't be easy.
We're all in favor of it, given na yung traffic czar natin ay mapagduduktong-duktong yung lahat ng agencies involved. Putting a traffic czar is going to be a very challenging idea.
The recommendation were issued after Metro Manila topped a transportation data specialist list of metro areas with the worst traffic in 2023. Aside from a traffic czar, MAP urged the government to organize the metro in 4 traffic management zones, revive and optimize the use of Mabuhay lanes and other alternate routes, prioritize mass public transport, as well as privatize the EDSA busway system, MRT3 and LRT2, among others. In a message to ABS-CBN News, Jonathan Hesmundo, the Executive Assistant to Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista, said they are setting a meeting with MAP to discuss their recommendations. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine economy falling short of government's growth target for 2023. The country's GDP print coming in at 5.6%, missing government's 6-7% goal. ABS-CBN's Jackie Pascual now joins us with more details. Jackie, what more can you tell us?
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. The Philippine economy expanded by 5.6% in 2023, but that's lower than the 7.6% in 2022 and lower than the government target of 6-7%. Carmina, the fourth quarter of 2023 also slowed down to 5.6% from 7.1% in the same period in 2022. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan said that despite the slowdown, he is pleased with the sustained economic figure, and he even said that the Philippines' GDP is still among the highest among Asian countries, which released the 2023 economic data. Reasons for the slowdown include external factors such as geopolitical risk, which in effect also affected Philippine exports. Inflation also had an impact as household final consumption expenditure drops to 5.6% in 2023 from 8.3% in 2022. Consumption of food and non-alcoholic beverages slowly increased only by 0.04%, way lower than the 5.7% in 2022. PSA Undersecretary Dennis Mapa said that inflation has impacted food consumption among Filipinos in the past year. However, he is seeing that with the easing of inflation rate, that spending may also increase in the months to come. Balisacan notes that there was growth in many sectors such as services, 7.2%, industry, 3.6%, and agriculture, forestry, and fishing at 1.2%. The officials remain optimistic for the growth this 2024. However, when asked if domestic political bickering could affect the potential growth of the economy, Balisacan said, in general, any country with political instability will hurt the economy and may turn off investors. He asserted that they maintain a growth target for this year of 6.5-7.5% and will reassess growth targets with the economic team in their next meeting.